The strong El Nino died in May, and since then we've had neutral conditions, neither El Nino nor La Nina. In the last few weeks, the sea surface temperature in the East Central Tropical Pacific has become just a little bit below average in the direction of La Nina, but so far not strong enough to call it a La Nina, although last week it was 6/10 of a degree below average. And if it stays that way for an appreciable length of time, we will be able to call it a weak La Nina. But 1 week alone is not enough. Below the surface of the ocean, we have more below average water. However, we're missing one little ingredient to get this event started, if it's going to start, and that is above average trade winds. We don't have them right now. If we don't get them, there may not be an efficient way to get that below average subsurface water to upwell up to the surface. We are expecting increased trade winds in the next month or two, and we're expecting a weak La Nina to be more likely than not. But the chances are only a little bit above 50% at this point. The models have backed off on the La Nina forecast strength and timing of onset. They've backed off a little bit, but they have not canceled it. They're still saying that it's most likely we'll get a La Nina, and most models who are that are predicting it say it'll be weak. So meanwhile, we wait. It will probably happen, but it may not be very impressive, and it may not set in right away. As far as the climate forecast coming out of this expected situation, we don't have very strong anomalies being forecast. We're expecting Indonesia to tend to be a little bit wetter than average coming up in the next season or two. And we have a United States winter forecast that looks something like a La Nina forecast with below average precipitation in the southern tier of states. And we're waiting to make sure the La Nina of a weak grade does come on. So that's how it looks right now. We have very warm temperature forecasts because in the wake of the El Nino, the tropical and extratropical atmosphere stays warm for several months, lagging behind the ocean temperature departures from normal. So we're expecting a very warm end to 2016. I show my age there, right? And we've been having record temperature months consecutively, and they should continue a little bit longer before the lagged effect of the La Nina starts setting in and putting an end to the record mean global temperature readings we've been having.